It's a holiday washout as far as the eye can see, caravans afloat on the Firth of Thames. Many homeowners fearing no better. In Kaiau, civil defence is in top gear, trying to contact the isolated occupants of around 500 homes dotted along the coastline.
Until we can get through to some of those pockets of the communities is just take care of yourself, make sure that you're looking after your neighbours and any vulnerable people around you.
Some roads closed by flooding, the local fire station and primary school now shelters for those forced to evacuate.
There's a number of people in there now just being taken care of by that by the fire force and the community members.
It's tough going across the Firth of Thames too. The State Highway North shredded in places by the stormy seas, forcing 60 people to take refuge at a hall in Te Puru. The wild weather leaving this truck precariously balanced on the Kōpū Bridge and whipping up usually calm bays around Auckland. Flooded motorways slowed traffic to a near standstill on Auckland's North Shore and startled a family awake in Remuera.
Next thing I know, I see the big tree go flying past my window and I go, uh-oh, what's happened now?
And the bad weather appears to be hindering attempts to stabilise this massive landslip. Locals tell us around 9 o'clock last night in the driving rain, about 8 metres of land on the far side of those cones went crashing down into the gully.
And while some are revelling in the effects of the wild weather, in Kaiau tonight there's concern for those it's left isolated and vulnerable. Nicole Bremner, One News.